Let's talk a little bit about hammers. The hammer itself cannot be harder than the tools that you're going to strike. There's a balance in the Rockwell hardness of the hammer that needs to be maintained. And it's around 54 Rockwell with a hammer made out of 4140. I don't want any impressions to be made in the hammer. If I do get an impression in the hammer, it's probably either my tools are too hard or my hammer's just a little bit soft. But if I can attain that 54 Rockwell on my hammer, it should maintain no matter what I'm striking. If this goes up, if that number goes up, and if this gets harder and harder and harder, and we get up into the 58s and the 60 Rockwells, now we're way harder than our tool. And we're dealing with some mass here. You know, the hammer is going to strike this small tool, and the tool is compressed between the anvil and this hammer when it's struck. So if this is extremely hard and I hit that with the force necessary to make that tool work, what's probably going to happen is I'm going to blow this tool up because I'm not getting any absorption into my hammer. And I want a certain amount of that. I want it to absorb a little bit of that blow into my tool. So that's just it. You just can't let this get that hard. If you're blowing up tools, there's a pretty good chance your hammer is too hard. So as you work with your hammer and you work on your anvil, any impression that's been pushed into your hammer, a dent or a cut line or anything on that or on this surface here, as you work that piece of material through that impression, there, wherever it is going to show up in your steel, in your work. So if you should miss for whatever reason and bing up a corner, if you're working close to an edge and you put a mark in your hammer, any of those times that you put a mark in this, stop and dress it out. Go back, clean it up, get that mark out of there, make sure that you have good smooth surfaces, nice radiused edges. Don't let a little chip on a corner, don't keep working with it. Go in, grind it off, and get rid of that chip.